exposed. Why does Kyrie Irving expose the basketball on his crossovers? We're gonna go over why he does it, how you can add this to your game, but you wanna make sure you pay attention to everything I give you. If you're not doing it the right way, the ball could get stolen, your coach might put you on the bench, or it just might not be effective and your defender could get back in front of you. One of the biggest things to understand with this is Kyrie is always in attack mode. So whenever you're thinking about the things in this video, always think about it in context of attacking. That's how it's gonna work best for you. We're gonna go into more detail as far as the different ways you can do that. Coach Jesse Minch with Get Handles Basketball, where we train harder and smarter so you can play like the pros. If that's something you're looking to do, subscribe and click the bell icon to catch the newest videos. First of all, so we're clear, let's talk about the different ways you can expose the basketball. Kyrie will do this a couple different ways, and we're gonna go into some of those specifics later in the video, but one way of exposing the basketball is just having it in your hand and putting it out in front of the defender, right? Could be here, could be here, could be extending it out here. When you're in a range where they could possibly get their hand on the basketball. The way he'll go about exposing the basketball from time to time is just bouncing it and leaving it all on its own where the defender could again try to steal it. So the first thing to keep in mind is Kyrie's always doing this with a purpose. In fact, there was actually a sports science talking about how he exposes the basketball often, but the defender, it takes him a few milliseconds to mentally process that the basketball is in front of them and they have the chance to steal it. By the time they realize that, boom, he's already changing direction. So a lot of times what he'll do when he's exposing the basketball is he'll use it knowing that he's setting them up to move one way. He'll push the basketball out here to get the defender move that way, and he knows that they're gonna react to that or knows that they're gonna try to steal the basketball. So either way, if they're trying to jump in front of them, they're coming this way. If they're going for the basketball, they're coming this way, but either way, they're coming a little bit this way, and he can use that to his advantage. So the same time they're moving that way, he's coming that way, boom, they get crossed up back. But I'll also use this in more sort of a reactional type of way. So a lot of times he'll like throw the basketball out there and leave it bounce on his own as bait, or he'll even just kind of show it as bait to see if the defender will reach for it. And from there, he's really quick with his reaction. So a big key on this is to work on your handles. I'm gonna give you some Kyrie specific drills at the end of this video that are gonna help you get those reactions like he has and that ball control necessary to pull this stuff off. But when he exposes it, from there, he's gonna make a really quick read, whether it's a free bounce exposed or the ball's in his hand. When the defender comes in, if they're coming too far this way, he's gonna go this way. Or he might even get a little flashier and go into like a sham guy. If they're coming too far this way, he's gonna explode past them. But the main point is he's gonna make that reaction instantly, so no matter what the defender does, it works against them. So if you're more of a beginner or intermediate ball handler, the way I would recommend you do this is have the basketball in your hand and use the basketball to sell a fake. So exposing it in a way where you're trying to get your defender to shift one way. If you're a little bit more like higher intermediate to advanced, you could play around more with baiting them by letting the basketball go and then make that quick reaction, or even having it in your hand to see what they're gonna do and then make the quick reaction. Something you wanna keep in mind with exposing the basketball like that is your coach isn't gonna necessarily appreciate you bouncing the ball out there all on its own or really showing it and waiting for the defender to go for the basketball. Probably wanna use it more in the situation where you're gonna sell a fake to change direction. That's the only main way you'd wanna do it if you're like at high school level or below. The second big reason that Kyrie will expose the basketball is to give a change of timing and a change of pace. If you're always playing at the same speed, and if you watch Kyrie, like he'll pull out some quick rapid fire combos, right? Pounding that ball hard, keeping it low, but then the occasional bigger fake is gonna throw their timing off, throw off their speed, make them think he's making that big movement, or give them that little thought, oh, I could steal the basketball now, and then they go for it, he takes advantage of it, right? Those little changes of speed are huge for Kyrie's game, they can be huge for your game as well. I wouldn't recommend you do this in a way where you're waiting for the defender to reach for the basketball if you're at high school or below, but you could definitely take advantage of floating the basketball in that hand from time to time, you know, going from quicker to dribbles to floating it a little more, exposing it a little more, and then selling a fake. Finally, one of the biggest things it does for Kyrie, and I'm not sure he really does it for this reason, but it definitely is a huge benefit, is the way it allows him to attack his defender. We talked about earlier in the video that you always wanna do this with an attack mentality in mind, right? Well, this is like for sure where you need to apply it. So a lot of times if you see Kyrie, when he'll dribble and float the basketball, he's a master at using those feet. He'll also do that when he bounces the basketball and sometimes leave it on its own. A lot of times he'll cover a lot of ground coming forward or sell some little jab step fakes. Dribbling the basketball a little bit higher while hanging it in your hand or letting it go frees up your feet to do a lot more versus if you're dribbling down low here, you can really only take one little step per dribble when you're dribbling at that height. But if you bring it up higher, I can add all kinds of little steps in the mix, right? Whether it's in my hand or not. Adding those types of exposed dribbles actually gives Kyrie a huge advantage. But there's three big keys to make sure this is working for you. You gotta make sure it's okay with your coach. You gotta make sure you're doing it in a way where it gives you an advantage. But most importantly, you have to have the handles and the ball control to make this work. This video right here has got some Kyrie Irving drills that are gonna help you a ton getting the kind of handle you need for this. This video covers five things that most coaches would say are wrong about Kyrie's handles, but actually give him a huge advantage. Click that like button, the subscribe button, the bell icon to catch the newest videos, and I'll see you in these videos next.